won't stop blowing. This is useful.
You're back. I'm elated. I know who you are, girl. The Nora who can control. Use your spear to take control of. Very well. Get up.
save these for the trail.
You didn't pass the trial. Try again if you're up to it. I know who you use. Good luck. You'll need it. Thank you. You beat the trial and earn. For this trial, you must use the cannon on a Ravager's back to take down other machines. You can shoot the cannon off or use the... Oh, and here's a special tip. A fine choice. Best of luck. Can't believe it. You've earned a blazing sun on the first try. You've earned a lot of suns, Nora. There are awards available for hunters like you. Speak to Idaba at the lodge in Meridian. I know who you are. Use your speed. Very well. Thank you.
Low and quiet does it. Looking good.
That run has earned you a blazing sun, Nora. Winning all those suns gives you access to elite gear at the lodge in Meridian. Find Idaba there, and she'll help outfit you.
I have to go.
As you like.
What can I do for you today? How are the trials going for you? Have enough marks for a weapon yet?
I believe I have enough here. What next?
You brought in all the sun marks at once. You're going to make a lot of hunters jealous. Not that it takes much. I'm pleased to present to you a Lodge Blast Sling, a Lodge Rope Caster, and the Lodge Warbow. Congratulations! You're a master hunter of the Lodge. All I can give you now is encouragement.
Talana, always a pleasure. I see you've brought your pet.
Greetings, Sunhawk. I hereby sponsor Aloy of the Nora for membership in the Hunter's Lodge.
No. Look at her. She's lowborn, a savage. This is beneath even you, Talana.
She has fulfilled the requirements. and Sun King Avad decreed the lodge should be open to all. Would you like to take it up with him?
The word of the Sun King is indeed law. Even though it would bring ruin to the lodge, so be it. Do you, Aloy of Venora, pledge to act rightly and nobly when in service to the lodge all the days to follow?
I do.
Members of the lodge, even though Tarkus is barely cold, I present to you Aloy of Venora. Member and Thrush, what say you all?
To the hunt!
Sponsoring an outlander. While you make meaningless gestures, I'll be finding Red Maw.
This is a good day.
I know why I hate Assis. Why do you?
My family has always boasted members in the lodge. My father and brother were both hawks. Assis let their sacrifice be forgotten.
What sacrifice?
They died in the massacre. They should be honored as hawks. Instead, Assis will not let anyone mention it.
How did your family come to be members of the lodge?
Karja noble houses have sent sons to the lodge for generations. Because they needed another place to lord over the commoners. I want to change that. The idea that someone is worthy or not by virtue of birth alone. Everyone thinks they have me pegged as soon as they hear Talana Khan Padish. I hate that.
I understand. My whole life I lived as an outcast from the Nora. They would have been the first to say I wasn't one of them. Yet as soon as I leave the sacred lands, everyone calls me Aloy of the Nora. It should be Aloy despite the Nora.
I didn't know. I'll remember that.
What happened in the massacre?
King Duran's paranoia knew no bounds. He sent thousands of innocents to die in the Sunring. When the hawks of the lodge called for him to stop the slaughter, he threw them in the ring too. Yet when the machines attacked the condemned, more hawks leapt into the ring to defend them. And my father and brother were among them.
I'm so sorry. What happened to the men in the Sunring?
They died fighting. If you wish to hear the story, Legan can tell it better. He saw it with his own eyes. I did not. The morning of the massacre, my father told me to meet him outside the city. He told me they were planning an escape. I waited for hours until a message came from my father. I had to leave the city. So I fled when I should have fought by his side.
He didn't want you to die with them.
Nor would he want their names forgotten. Especially by the man who benefited most from their deaths, Assis.
What's Red Maw?
Few have seen it. A thunderjaw marked by years of battle. Some say it still bears the marks of over a dozen hunters on its flank. How many it has trampled along the way, we may never know. When members go hunting and never return, we often blame Red Maw. But to me, it's more than legend. It's the only machine that will unseat Assis. My sponsor nearly had it, but he didn't make it.
I'm sorry.
Tarkus sponsored me out of loyalty to my family. He was my last link to them, besides the lodge itself. I have to unseat Assis. Now that you're a Thrush, you should improve your reputation. Why do you hunt down a Thunderjaw and a Stormbird?
You want me to go trophy hunting?
You're not just any Thrush. You're mine. And you better make me look good.
But what about Red Maw?
I will find him. And when I do, I expect you to be there.
You're looking for artifacts.
Yes, but I'm no profiteer. Sun King Avad has named me an envoy to the Banuk. I work on their behalf, looking for sacred relics to return to their homeland, Ben-Ur. I'm especially interested in wooden figures that are sometimes found near Benuk rock paintings. If you have any, I have valuables to trade for them.
You said the king named you an envoy to the Benuk?
Yes. I've been to Ben-Ur many times, and the Wirik chiefs trust me. I help them maintain diplomatic ties with Avad. Some say they're a mysterious people, but their ways make a lot of sense to me. All you have to do is be the best. Doesn't matter if you're born high or low, man or woman. They respect skill, not some fool notion of heritage.
I see the appeal.
I wish more Karja did. Anything they don't understand, they call backward or savage.
Tell me more about these Benuk figures.
Simple wood sculptures, made by Arnak, a legendary hunter who was exiled from Ben-Ur for killing his chief. He left the figures near painted stones in places that reminded him of his homeland. Later, his tribe declared him innocent. Now they see him as a kind of wandering hero and want those figures back. I do what I can to help him get them, including trade for them, if you have any. You ready? Let's trade then. Come on back if you find any Benuk goods. I pay well for Benuk relics, Outlander.
How's that wrestling arm of yours?
I should have been a crafter. They make good shards.
Ah, you're back. Did you bring me something lovely? Ah, let us haggle over this beautiful bounty. Till we meet again, my noble Nora.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
Enough.
never know when I might need these. Saving these for the trail.
issue in that way. That's right. No one here.
Men down.
Like we got a cold one.
Looks like I'm clear. And one of these. Thank you.
corpse.
Haven't you got anything better to do? That's their alarm signal. Better keep them off it.
See them.
Finally. Feel the ground softening up. With the alarm.
Close!
There's the prisoners. You're coming with me. I'm gonna get you out.
Thank you.
on foot from here. I won't get far going this way.
Thank you. It's not much, but maybe this will show you how grateful I am. You have my thanks, and the thanks of my family.
Clear that up later.
I can't carry more. That was worth it. Good meat. it. Can you see here? Get on with it. No space. Snow. It's not getting any warmer out here. Just stay out of the way. God, I found this. Low and quiet does it. Can stop tensing up. Forget about traveling light. Down. Can smell the new day on the wind. This has to be the Banuk camp that Vilgan told me about. So what happened to the other mercenaries he sent? Looks like a Nora. Tomorrow, we'll see what the shamans have learned from the machine spirits.
The machines are docile.
It's like they've already been overridden.
Well prepared for the hunt, I hope.
Shaman, you're trying to understand the machines here, too?
Yes, Nora. And taking my time with my studies, between you, me, and the spirits, I appreciate the peace. Not just from the machines. There are many changes in Ban-Ur. The hunters and shamans bicker without end.
What about?
How best to deal with a harsher world? The hunters, they don't want it back the way it used to be. And we shamans find ourselves able to explain less and less. So many are exiles now, sent to wander. Here, no one argues. So I welcome mystery.
They say even the ice in the grove rings with the blue light, with the spirit's call.
The spoils of the hunt have been a little light lately. We should find a few machines, earn the spirit's favor.
Grazer dung.
I'm sorry?
Frozen grazer dung. This ravager led me here. I chased it down from the rivals, where it killed a great ice hunter. Tore him in two. A challenge I accepted. But when it reached this camp, the fury left it.
Isn't that a good thing?
Tikuk says it's a gift. What is a gift but a reward that you didn't earn? The machines are meant to challenge us. Now I'm stuck here guarding the shamans.
Greetings, Nora. I am Tikuk.
Shaman, I've never seen anything like this.
The blue light is strong here. My people traveled far from the heights of Ban-Ur to experience it for themselves.
The blue light?
The light of the machine spirits. It is all around us. It settles upon us. This is how it used to be, before they grew angry.
I know about the derangement, but I didn't think the machines were ever this calm. What is it about this place?
We don't really know. We sing, and we listen to the machine songs.
Tikuk, have any other Outlanders come through here recently?
Some Asaram, yes. They were convinced the machines were malfunctioning. As if machines were mere devices in need of repair. Well, that is how the Asaram see the world, is it not? They ate with us. Then, when they were satisfied there was nothing they could explain, they left with the Northern Light.
The machines sing to you?
To each other. You are a hunter. You must have heard their communions and hymns, their calls and cries. We're not meant to understand, but we shamans try to interpret. What is the song that angered them so, that turned them upon us? What song soothes them? Does it thrum in the air here, just outside of hearing? How can we heal the machine world?
What's with the big guy?
I was drawn to this place in a storm. At first, I thought the keening was the wind, snapping off the mountain's frozen face. But no, it was the Thunderjaw's song. I found it crouched on its haunches, its metal unmoving, and I took shelter beneath it. When the storm cleared, its singing done, perhaps the spirit left its great shell, or perhaps it slumbers and remains. So we have not stripped and gleaned this one. We treat it with the care it is owed.
Do you mind if I look around more, Tikuk?
Speak, trade, listen. You are welcome. No harm will come to you here.
So it's not the Banuk that are doing this. There's something about this place. They can't see it, but maybe my focus can.
May there be songs in your name.
Keep your skills sharp.
There, a signal. And the source is at the top of the mountain. I'd better look into it.
Example's a good one.
This is how the village must have gotten up and down the mountain. So just...
Right beyond your jumping shard purses! You can't just leave us here!
Did Vilgun send you? I guess shards can buy a conscience.
Never mind that. Nora girl, you have to stop the others. Up ahead, we snuck up here, uncovered some kind of ancient device, plain as an anvil. That's what affects the machines.
The other bungheads voted to take it to Pitchcliff for auction. But it's taken a beating already. Like it dropped from the sky.
We tried to stop them digging it out. Without that thing up here, those Banuk will be massacred.
I'll stop them. You two get out of here. It sounds like you've already done enough damage.
Well, that's a fair appraisal.
What have you done?
Who are you? You're not one of those Banuk.
Too late. Let me look at it.
Hold on. This was our delve. We did the work. You want to put your axe in? What's this thing worth to you?
I don't know about this. This was your idea. You started it, you can finish.
All right. Could be this thing's just scrap, but even scrap has a price. So I'll ask again, what's it worth to you?
It's worth more to me than you are. You still want to negotiate?
Forget it. All he's ever given me is black toes.
They've made a mess of this. Catastrophic malfunction. This is long ago. And it's been sending a signal all this time. Fading out. I have to get back to the camp before the machines tear it apart. They've already started attacking.
The hunt is back!
The machines are angered. Keep your distance. Hunters,
yes.
Defend the camp. Do what you must.
I don't fear it. You'll hear my song, machine. A sharp song. Hear my song, machine. A sharp song.
Too late for you, Buzz.
The hunt is back. Rend at me. I don't fear it. Now you'll hear my song, machine. A sharp song.
My best work, but it'll do.
Done.
Nora, did you know this change would come upon us?
Not exactly. Although I know there is a lot changing in our world. This time it was outsiders. Those Oseram thought.
The Oseram do not think. They will never understand the balance between us, between man and machine. Now the blue light has gone, and we are left with many songs, but more for mourning than gratitude.
So what now? Will you go back to your homeland?
When we teach the young to walk on shifting ice, we say, the secret is taking one step, then the next. Perhaps one day, we will understand the machine's mysteries.
I hope so. Good luck, Teacook.